I first visited this part of Gold Bar Park at the end of July 2015 and was surprised to find so much insect activity around this earthen bank. After taking some photographs and posting them online, I soon found out that the most numerous insects here were in fact small wild bees, sometimes known as Zephyr dialectus. South-facing banks of creeks and streams are typical of the locations where the communal nests of Zephyr dialectus can be found. The species is Lasioglosum zephyrum, a small helictine bee commonly known as a sweat bee. And Google soon led me to the life cycle and behavior of the primitively social bee Lasioglosum zephyrum helictidae by Suzanne W.T. Batra, published in 1966. Almost all the information I have used in this video comes from this study, which is available at the Biodiversity Heritage Library and is copyright free. An overview of the species can also be found at Wikipedia. Nest holes are usually found near the banks of streams. They enter at a 90 degree angle to the soil surface and run horizontally. Each circular entrance is about 2 millimeters in diameter, where the burrow itself is about 4 millimeters in diameter. During her research, Batra found that the largest nest had 38 branches. The largest amount of active cells was 85, and the maximum number of females in the nest was 45. Now, a quick synopsis of the life cycle of the Zephyr dialectus. Nests are begun by a single queen when they emerge from hibernation after being fertilized the previous year. She will dig a new burrow and then create a small cell. Nectar and pollen is then mixed to form a flattened ball onto which an egg is deposited. The cell is then sealed with soil. After hatching, the larva feeds on the pollen ball. In about 38 days, will go through 5 instar stages before emerging as an adult. After about 4 cells are developed, the queen rests. The first broods to emerge are mostly female. There is no sharply defined case system with these bees. Young females begin by building cells and then move to guarding and foraging, and may also contribute eggs to the nest at any stage. At the nest entrance, we may see a female guard, and the bees that leave are either foragers or newly emerged males. The males will now live the rest of their lives outside the nest. By August, a large amount of males have emerged and are found in the general nest area, where they tend to gather at conspicuous areas nearby. They also spend time hovering over nest areas, forming a large portion of the visible activity near the nest. Males will attempt to mate with foraging females on flowers and when they are resting or grooming on nearby plants. Females learn to re-enter the nest quickly, because any hesitation at the nest entrance can lead to mating attacks by males. From this we can understand that the bees recorded hovering near the nest are mostly males, and those with more direct flight paths to the nest entrance and entering the nest are returning female foragers. Foragers return with pollen and nectar, but in the many recorded instances of females returning to the nest, only once did I observe a female with packed scopa. Females sometimes enter the wrong nests, but soon emerge. Males seldom enter nests that are guarded, but they do occasionally manage to enter nests to mate with females. Let's observe some of the activity now. Thank you. animals sometimes seem to attempt mating with guards at the nest entrance, but in only one unusual circumstance was I able to record this, which will be shown in the last video.